First you will need a spare monitor, a spare video output, a spare USB keyboard and mouse, two spare USB ports, and some virtualization software such as VMware or VirtualBox. If you are using VMware, then the first thing you will need to do is edit the VMX file. If you are using VirtualBox, then you will not need to do this. To do this, open up the virtual machine that you want to use, then look down the bottom under Virtual Machine Details where it says Configuration File, and then browse to that location. Then look for the file that says Virtual Machine Configuration File next to it, then open it with Notepad. Scroll down to the bottom and add the following two lines of code. There will be a copy of the code in the description for if you want to copy and paste it. Save changes, and then exit the file. Next, connect the second monitor. Then hold down the fourth leg Windows key and keep pressing the letter P until Extend is selected. Next, plug in the USB keyboard and mouse. Start up the virtual machine, and then drag it onto the second monitor, then click Full Screen. If you are using VMware, then go up to the toolbar at the top, then go to VM, then click Removable Devices, then select the name of the keyboard that you want to control that screen, then click OK. Then do the same and select the mouse that you want to control that screen. If you are using VirtualBox, then go down to the toolbar at the bottom of the screen, then click Devices, then click USB, then select the keyboard that you want to control that screen, then do the same and select the mouse that you want to control that screen. Then go back down to the bar at the bottom of the screen, then uncheck Mouse Integration. And here we have it. I am now able to control each screen separately, running off the same PC. If you are having problems with a host's taskbar showing on top of the guest's taskbar on the second screen, then you may have to go to your host's taskbar properties and then uncheck Show Taskbar on All Displays